Hello, good evening, guys. Here we have Charlie and Andrea and Carito. So welcome, Charlie. Good evening. I guess you are playing with your tablet or what, something like that. Oh, okay, that's good. Hello, Andreita, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
I hear you.
Without problem. Okay. And how was your day, Andreita?
Normal day.
Normal day. No surprises? Yes.
Anything.
Okay. You told me the last time that your vacations are every year, right?
Yes.
15 days or more or less?
No, 15.
15. And let's see. Related to the vacations, it is difficult to decide, right? The company gives you the dates. Is that true?
Yes.
Hmm? Okay. And it is in June, July, February?
In January.
In January. Oh, yes. Okay. Okay. So you can enjoy. After having a very hard, well, after having hard days during December, you can have your vacations in January, right?
Yes. Okay. ¿Cómo se dice? Aprovechar, teacher.
Take advantage.
Okay. Take advantage. Rest.
Rest. And maybe you can go out with your family or something like that, right? But yes. Mainly rest, right?
Yes.
No, you deserve it. Okay. Thank you, Andreita. Here we have also Helen. I guess Helen is on her way, right, Helen? And here we have Kevin as well.
Hi, teacher.
Thank you, Kevin. Let's see. Here we have Diana, Carito, and Jasmine, I guess. So to start and to take advantage of the time, let's see. The topic is simple past yes, no questions. It means questions, closed questions, okay? In which the answer, it's definitely only yes or no. But we're going to see some other types of questions related to the past, okay? Remember that this is the class number 13, okay? So this is really important. Really important because we are about to finish. Just give me a minute. Okay, so here we start with the class number 13. It means that after this class, we're having just seven classes and we finished. Solo siete clasesitas más después de esta. And we're going to finish. Okay, the first question is you just answer yes, no, and maybe a short or a brief answer. Would you adopt a boy or a girl? If the answer is no, well, there's no problem. If the answer is yes, it's something that is positive as well. So we're going to start in this case with Charlie. So Charlie, would you adoptarías boy or girl or not necessary?
Yes.
You don't have problems with that?
No, I don't see any problem.
Okay, Charlie, in my opinion. Are you planning to have another kid? Or no, no. Not by now?
No, así all the process que implica.
That implies.
Mm-hmm. Imply no.
Okay.
But have an boy in adoption, yes.
Okay. I guess that is something positive. Okay, so it can be included in your plans. Okay, thank you, Charlie. Okay, that's good. But I know that having one girl, it's a lot of work. Okay, so here we have also Damari. Hello, good evening, Damari.
Older.
I'm sorry, teacher.
Problem. Okay, everything okay today?
Yes, yes, teacher.
Okay, I like it.
Yes.
Nothing in comparison to the Monday, right? Okay. So, tell me, would you have would you adopt a boy or a girl, or it is not in your plans, or you think it is not necessary in the future? Sure.
This topic no es lo que mandó.
No.
Ah, okay.
La otra es speaking activity. Esta es solo una respuesta bien breve que casi siempre hago unas preguntitas relacionadas a ese mismo tema.
Okay.
Aquí la pregunta es, ¿adoptarías a un niño o una niña?
Uh-huh.
So, the answer.
Yes, teacher. I like it.
Okay.
No.
No problem. Yes, you can see a lot of kids over there, yes, and without parents. Yes, and they are suffering as well. So
I like to adopt.
Okay.
A boy or a girl.
And specifically, a boy or a girl? Or a girl. No preference? Ah, girl. Okay.
Yes. That's,
okay, very nice. And Andreita, what do you think about it?
I would like adopt a girl.
A girl, okay.
Yes.
A little girl. Wow, that could be nice, right? You can teach her a lot of things, right? And you can understand. Thank you. And what about you, Kevin? Would you adopt a boy or a girl or none? It is not in your plans. Well, it's not necessary. What do you think?
Pienso que no importa como que el género, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
Y pues sí, se lo hiciera.
Okay, yes. Thank you. And what about Marlon? Hello there, Marlon. Good evening.
Good evening. Hello.
Okay. Hello. Nice to see you again. So here we have this short question. What do you think about it? Would you or not?
I won't. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't.
Okay. Yeah. Even
because I have two children, and I think there is another family that would like to adopt.
Uh-huh.
And if I don't have the facilities. Better I can be with my two children and no more.
Yes. Curado.
A menos que yo lo fabrique.
Yeah, okay. That's another story. Okay.
No, pero sí, yeah, serious. I think I won't. I wouldn't.
Okay. It is not included in your plans, right? Okay.
No,
that's
it's
a very good point of view. Thank you, Marlon. Okay, here we have Jasmine. Good evening, Jasmine. Ah, with the baby over there. Okay.
Good evening.
Okay, is the baby all right? Very calm, right? Wow, she's so beautiful. Very nice. Okay, no problem, Jasmine. We're going to be over here, okay? If you can participate, let me know. If not, okay. Understand that you are taking care of the baby. Okay, thanks, Jasmine. Well, I guess she has already a baby girl, so you're not thinking about adoption.
No,
you are very busy. Okay, you have a lot of work. Okay, thanks, Jasmine. What about Carito? Could you give me your opinion about it? Hello. Well, I guess she's kind of busy right now. Maybe she can participate later. Carmencita.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Carmen. We are talking about, would you adopt a boy or a girl?
I would like to adopt a girl.
A girl. Do you have girls? Daughters?
Two boys.
No. Only two boys, right?
Yes.
Similar to
but
Marlon.
I want to be with more financial possibilities.
Yes, facilities. It is not a matter of I want a boy, I want a girl. It is a matter of if you have the facilities, okay? If you have the possibilities, okay?
Pero okay. No lo descarto.
Yes, okay. There is a possibility, okay? Yes.
Yes.
In the future. Okay, a girl specifically, right? Because you have two boys now.
Yes, teacher, a girl.
Yeah, yes. I guess most of moms would like to have a girl, because in my case, my mom always says that she would like to have, she would like to have a girl, because we are three boys, three men. So it is kind of difficult because we have grown up and four men at home and only her, like a woman. So it is kind of.
Yo conozco, dije, un caso de una amiga que los papás tuvieron dos niñas y dijeron, okay, el tercero tal vez sale niño.
Baby boy.
Y bueno, estaban esperando el tercer bebé y salieron trillizas.
Wow, wow, wow.
Mi amiga es de las trillizas.
Okay, that's too much. Okay, so at least, I'm sorry, at last five girls.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, but that's nice.
Así que yo ya no.
That's beautiful, but those girls maybe thinking of a boy. Okay, now they have to take care of them. Three more. Wow. Okay. Thanks. And
I would like have twins. Me.
Twins. You would like to have twins.
Yes.
Okay.
This is my.
it's like one of your dreams, maybe your wishes. But in your family, is there or are there twins?
No.
Right. Yes.
No. This is the problem.
So there are not too much possibilities, okay, for that to happen. But it's like I would like to. So perfect. Mercy, good evening.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Hello, Mercy. What about this? Would you adopt a boy or a girl?
Yes. Yes.
A boy or a girl?
Ambos.
Both.
Important.
Okay, you already have a girl, right?
Yes, he's a healthy, si es un niño desamparado.
Yes,
who needs love, and he is girl.
Okay, yes, and that's something positive, right, Mercy? To help a boy or a gay, a girl that he or she maybe doesn't have the love of some parents. They don't have the support, el apoyo.
Yes. Sí, that, sí. Fuera un niño desamparado que necesita amor y de muchas necesidades, sin dudarlo lo haría.
Yes, okay. That's a good point. Okay, thanks, Mercy. What about now, Claudia? Hello, Claudia. Good evening.
Hello, teacher. Okay, good evening.
Good evening. We're talking about this. What's your opinion? Yes, you would like, or maybe not.
Yes.
Okay. A boy or a girl?
Opino de lo mismo que okay. Mercy, creo que
the
es.
Same, the same opinion, sí. Like Mercy's. Yes, why not?
Yo lo haría.
Okay, why not to help? Thank you. Maritza, and then we go with Edgar.
I think I know.
I wouldn't.
I couldn't, but like Mercy,
if there is a kid in necessities,
I think
I would, yes. And there is something that is very common in here in our country and some other countries, in which maybe you can see a neighbor or you can see maybe a boy or a girl that maybe he or she's suffering, people help with the studies, right? Or yes. It's like give support, dan apoyo, como dicen apadrinar. Yeah, that's something that always happens. It is not necessary to adopt full or completely, but maybe we can help, right? With those kind of kids. Okay, I like your point of view. Yes, I like it. Okay, and Edgar, right? Are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Could you give me your opinion about this?
Okay. I would like a dog.
A boy or a girl?
Yeah, a boy.
A boy, yes, a baby boy.
Quizás, maybe, ¿no? ¿Cómo es? Ajá. Maybe because I like have a boy.
Ah, you like to have a boy, yes. By now, yes, Edgar, by now, do you have kids?
No. No, no tengo.
Okay, that's good. Maybe in the future, okay. Thanks, Edgar. Okay, very nice. What about Dianita? Are you there, Dianita?
Hi, teacher. Good evening. Oh, in my case, I couldn't.
You couldn't, okay. You already have a kid, right? So
yes.
You're kind of busy. Ocupadita. Yes, I know. But it is good, you know. Nowadays, I see that, or it is evident that some parents, they take care of having few kids. Tienen pocos hijos. In comparison to the past.
Economía.
Yes, yes, but because you are aware, ustedes son conscientes también. Bueno, but there are many factors. You are aware. Ustedes son conscientes about the economy, facilities, and you want to give to the kids the best, right? Not only related to the economic things, but also support, love, attention. But in the past, there were like parents having 6 kids, 8
Los
kids.
Que Dios me dé, decía.
Yes, there wasn't a television, maybe. Quizás no tenían televisión, or I don't know. Why, but there were a lot of kids in there. And now I can see that parents think like carefully. Some of them, algunos ya piensan como, ya lo piensan dos veces, to think twice. Okay. So thank you, Dina. What about Elsa?
Hi, teacher.
Hello, Elsa, good evening. What's your opinion about this?
Yes. I like it.
Ah, you like Elsa? How many kids? How many kids do you have?
Que si tengo niños.
Yes.
Yes, one boy.
Okay, one. Yes.
A boy.
If you adopt, what would it be? A boy or a girl?
A boy.
A boy. Okay. Okay. Nice election. Thank you. And to finish, Beatriz, are you there at home? Okay, maybe she's going to be ready in a minute. Edenilson. Okay, Ede, I know that you already have a baby girl and it is difficult to think about it, right? But maybe in the future, or it's not in your plans?
It's not in my plans, but if my wife and I wish a boy and she can't or I can't
have it, or if there are having, few possibilities, hay pocas posibilidades, right? Better to adopt. Okay, that's good. I can hear you, Ede. Hello. I can hear you.
At the moment, no. Sorry.
Okay. Yes. Creo que se escuchaba lejos.
At the moment, no.
I'm sorry.
No. There is an interference. Hay una pequeña interferencia por ahí.
Okay. At the moment, no. Only with Zoe. But in the future, maybe.
Okay. Sure, maybe. Okay. That's fine. Thank you, Ede. And here we have also, well, I guess most of them have replied related to this. So, again, this is the class number 13. And the topic is simple past, yes, no questions. Okay. So, this is the class number 13. It means that we have 7 classes left. And we have maybe the what? A lot of percentage. Okay. So we're going to see this all, every, each. There are similar words that maybe we confuse when we want to use it and apply it to some sentences, some ideas. So before going to this, I'm going to check the attendance list. So please say hello if you are there. And Mercy, hello.
Hello, teacher.
Okay, that's nice. Andreita.
Hi.
Hello there. Charlie.
Here.
Thanks. And Carmen.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Claudia.
Present.
Nice. Carito, I know that you're there.
Present.
Thanks, Carito. Maritza.
Hello.
Oh, Diana.
Present.
Nice. Eden Nilsson. Elsa.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Damari.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Helen.
Present, teacher.
Perfect. Vladimir.
Present.
Manuel. No, Manuel. Right. Marlon. Hello.
Hello. Present.
Thank you. Susie. No, Susie. And Jasmine. Yes, you're over there.
Present.
Thanks. And Beatrice. Okay, so we're going to start. Thank you.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher, cuando estaba en la lista entró Manuel.
Yes, I can see him. Thank you, Charlie. Yes.
Ah, okay. Okay. Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher. Gracias, Charlie.
Edgar, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yes, Edgar. I'm going to check it. Thanks, Edgar.
Okay.
Okay, so all, every, each. Okay, all, every, each. Let's see, all. Marlo, could you help me with this? We use all.
We use all to talk about the total number of things considered as a group and not individually.
Continue, please.
Minimum of 3 things. All is used for the entire amount of something.
Okay.
All plus plural noun.
Yeah. All houses.
All houses need to have a roof. Mm-hmm. All can be used to make a generalization. All elephants are slow.
Thank you, Marlon. Thank you. So easy. All means todo, significa todo, okay? It's for total of groups or something. It can be fruits, people, animals, types of cars, okay? So that's it, okay? And here we have every, and for every, I will need Charlie, collectively, right? So every, we use.
Collectively. We use every to talk about things collectively as a group more than individually.
Hmm?
Not for two things. Every is usually for a large number. Every plus singular noun. Every house on the street look the same. Can be used for how often something happens. I take a break every 2 hours.
Okay, that's it.
Además no lo canso a ver. Ah, como no.
Every plus number plus plural noun. Es que está bien pequeñito. So can you see collectively, ¿verdad? Un tanto colectivo, okay? Every. So every significa también, como decimos, everybody, ¿verdad? Se refiere a todos, okay? Everybody, every person, okay? Every color, okay? Pero también podría, pues, tomarse como cada color, cada persona. Pero siempre hablando, always talking about in groups, okay? Collectively. And here we have each. And then for this each, I have Andrea, please. we use each to talk one by one.
We use each to talk about the individual members of a group as separate items for two things or more. Each is usually for a small number. Each plus singular noun. Each house on the street has a different number. Each of plus you use them. They gave each of us a small gift.
Yes, that's it. Thank you, Adreita. Each house on the street has a different number, ¿verdad? Cada casa de sobre la calle tiene un número diferente. Y lo otro, she gave each of us a small gift. Nos dio a cada uno de nosotros un pequeño regalo. Okay, so here we have all, every, each for us to have an idea. Y lo último, I say goodbye to all the students as they leave the room. Goodbye, students. Yo digo adiós a todos los estudiantes. And then, I say goodbye each student as they leave the room. Digo adiós a cada estudiante en tanto van saliendo. Okay, goodbye, Mary. Goodbye, Daniel. So that's it. For example, when I say goodbye, I say at the end, at 10 p.m., I say goodbye to all of you. I don't say goodbye, Diana. Goodbye, Tamara. No, I don't say goodbye to each of you. I say goodbye to all of you. Okay, so this is like the key for these words. Now, let's go to the worksheet. That's something that we were studying yesterday. So, we're going to use the simple exercises completing the following sentences with the words provided below in the past simple tense. Okay, and this is easy. So, we can use these verbs that are regular verbs, easy verbs, son verbos fáciles, regulares, okay? So, we can use in affirmative form. For this, we're going to have the first person, Carmen Cira, and then Maritza.
Teacher, no he identificado todavía cómo es ahí.
Okay, I'm going to give you some time. Maritza, any idea? And after Maritza, we're going to have Mercy.
The news. The refine name, them.
Okay, the news.
The refine them. No, no me suena.
Okay, I'm going to give you time. I'm going to give you time, okay? Mercy, what about you? Any ideas? And after Damari. If not, if you need time, just tell me. Let me know.
No, teacher.
No. Okay. More time. Damari. Use your superpowers. Okay, no, Damari. Okay. I'm going to give you time. Okay.
Estoy procesando ahorita, teacher.
Processing. Okay. Marlon, what about you?
Well, of course. I think in the first one, he dries
his
face with a handkerchief.
Yes. Okay. Dry. Okay. I'm going to give a handkerchief. Sorry. Okay.
Next teacher.
Oh, ay, cabrón, no creo que te la gane. Okay. Okay, I'm going to give you, give me 5 seconds. Okay. Handkerchief, it means pañuelo. Anoten eso. That's important. Handkerchief, especially for gentlemen, for men. Okay. Handkerchief significa pañuelo, but we can say hanky. Hanky is same, okay, pañuelo, okay, that we use to dry. We use the hanky to dry, right? Here we have, I'm sorry. Hanky to dry our face, the tears, or if a person is crying, you can lend your hanky or handkerchief. Okay, here we have Carmen Cira. She doesn't want to lose his
The last teacher,
the wounded
soldier, y ahí tendría que decir el verbo en pasado.
Yep.
Right.
Okay.
With pain.
Yes, the wounded soldier cried with pain. Porque estaba herido, the wounded soldier. Yes.
Okay.
Good. Okay. Who's the other? Okay.
Teacher number four.
Four.
No, number five. He, Danny.
Danny is one of my cousins. You can say deny.
Deny.
Negó. Como cuando niegan las mentiras y otras cosas. So denied.
Deny.
¿Cómo es en pasado denied? Denied.
Denied all the accusations.
All, ya ven, todas. All the accusations. Thank you. Okay, Mercy. Now ready?
Number three. Four.
Or?
I replied.
Yes, I replied
to his letter last week.
Perfect. That's it. Maritza, any idea?
No, teacher. Excuse me.
Okay, let's go with Elsa.
Number three.
Satisfied. Okay, thank you. Okay, number two is kind of tricky, right? Charlie, what about number two? What's your opinion about this?
The news. Oh, I don't know.
Okay,
can say I don't know.
The news terrified
them. Terrified them or identify them. Yes, that's it. Thank you. Very nice, Andreita. Estaba tu momento, había llegado. Okay, let's see affirmative. Okay, remember that we use these irregular verbs in the past. Okay, so to start here, we're having Dianita and then Jasmine.
Okay, the number one, sería they went to the beach.
Okay, perfect. Jasmine, Claudia.
Einstein got the Nobel Prize.
Okay, Einstein. Einstein what?
Got.
Yes, Einstein got the Nobel Prize, okay. Thank you. Okay, Claudia, and then we go with Kevin. Okay, Kevin, because Claudia's not ready.
Okay. Number seven.
Okay.
She used had.
Had, excellent, a baby. Yes, perfect. Thank you. Okay. Now let's go with Manuel and then Edgar.
Okay. My father forgot the keys.
Forgot the keys. Thank you. Okay. Edgar, Helen.
Okay. I need the correct answer.
I knew. I knew the correct answer. Thank you. Helen, and then we go with Eden Nilsson.
Number eight.
Mm-hmm.
I know the correct answer. Yes,
perdón,
teacher. Okay,
he. The dove or the girl?
The girl drives.
Okay, the girl drove. Okay.
It's for bike.
Thank you. Eden Nilsson And to finish, we're having Edgar.
Okay. The dove flew far away.
Thank you. And Edgar, he...
Sí, ya pasé, pero sería...
I'm sorry. Bueno, dale con todo.
He gave me a kiss.
He gave.
Mm-hmm. Gave me.
Okay, thank you. When is the right time to tell a kid that he, she was adopted? Adopted. ¿Cuándo es el momento adecuado, correcto, para decirle a un niño que él o ella fue adoptado? Okay. For this, I will need Andrea to give me her opinion about this topic, please.
Okay. I have no idea what the appropriate age is. I think I will be better to tell him since he was a little.
Aha, uh-huh, from since kid, little kid, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a little by little, okay. So for him not, or for her not to have like an impact, okay.
Uh-huh, cabal.
So that's yes. The reason. Uh-huh, cabal, teacher. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's your opinion. Yes, very nice. Carmen, what about you? Thank you, Andre. A very good opinion.
I think since was little teacher.
Okay. Yes, for that kid to know that it is not a bad thing to be adopted, right? But there are different forms to say, different ways to say. Okay. So the kid maybe the kid wouldn't feel like rejected, para que no se sienta rechazado, rejected, okay? So you can say it in different forms, or even you can tell stories, puedes contarle historias, a lot of tales, cuentos, about adopted kids, right?
In different forms, it depends for your age.
Mm-hmm.
Para que vaya entendiendo.
Yes, yes, that's it. For him or to her to understand, porque va entendiendo, okay? Little by little. Thank you. Damari, hello.
Hi, teacher.
Hello, hello. ¿Ah, me estás viendo la palabra?
No.
Ah, pues ya estuvo, dale.
No.
Aquí estaba así, bello. Ah, okay, Damari wants to participate. Please go ahead.
No, estaba... okay.
De Maritza. Mm-hmm.
Teacher, there is no exact age, but I think when the people or person is a teenager.
Mm-hmm.
Teenager, because he or she is prepared for her mind.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And he or she is growing, va creciendo, it's maturing, va madurando, okay, little by little.
I think it's necessary tell us. Decirle.
Yes, to tell. Yes.
To tell.
It shouldn't be a secret, right? It is not a good idea to be a secret. Imagine when that kid gets older and he or she is an adult and she discovers that the impact is going to be like bigger, I guess. So that it is better to tell him or her in advance.
But in my opinion, can grow with the stigma that is adopted.
Oh, okay, that's another point, Charlie. So yeah, maybe
another point.
The kid, maybe you say, or your opinion is referred to the kid, maybe could have like too much, well, that impact could have incidents, maybe in their feelings, in the way of thinking, like a type of trauma. Algo así, algo si te refieres, okay? Yeah, Okay, so in your opinion, Charlie, when could it be, or would it be the best age or the best time to tell?
In my opinion, I don't know when is the best time to say something. As important as that, it's a rather delicate delicate and complicated subject to address. It's maturity of both age and reasoning, so that an act of love such as adopted son, it's not going to be interpreted as a deception.
Mm-hmm. Could it be like a kind of deception? Okay, depending, right? It depends. So in your case, depending. Do you think it is a good idea to tell the kid or better to be a secret?
In my opinion, lo que uno no sabe, no le molesta.
Okay, if you don't know.
In my opinion.
Okay, if you don't know, maybe it is not going to hurt you. Okay, good opinion. That's your opinion. That's okay. Thanks. Thanks for your ideas. Okay, Maritza, then we continue. Maritza, go ahead, please.
I think that it's time to tell a child that he or she is adopted is when he can remember. ¿Cómo se dice uso de razón?
Reasoning. Okay, razonamiento, reasoning.
Mm-hmm. Time he can remember.
Okay.
Gradually teaching the parents to son, he is adopted, but they love him.
Yes, the si parents fuera, show that they love
as
him.
As if he were a own
child. Yes, I agree with that. It is good. And the treatment, el trato, the treatment, after saying that, doesn't have to change. No tendría que cambiar, okay? The no. Same, right? And on the contrary, should be like expressing love, expressing comprehension, and some other things that help to the kid to grow up like healthy. Para que crezca saludable, okay? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Maritza. So now let's see to these descriptions. Mrs. Mendoza. And here we have Mr. Torres. They are describing their experience with two different companies. Okay, they are describing to two different companies. For this, we'll need that. Elsa, please, could you help me with Mrs. Mendoza? I had a problem.
I have a problem with the payroll system, but a technician came to help me with it. He solved it, but he didn't say anything. He even changing me for a price.
Mm-hmm.
He gave me a copy of the report, but I didn't understand it. Besides all that, I forgot to mention that it came very late.
Okay, so here we have that she had, thank you, Elsa, a problem with the payroll, que es la nómina de pagos, okay, o la planilla, okay, system. And the technician came, and the technician solved the problem, but he didn't say anything. And when we want a person to repair something, sometimes we are waiting to listen to that expert to say what is going on, what's the problem. But there are some technicians or some experts that they say, and they say, okay, your computer has this, the system has this, or your car is having some problems like this, this, this. But there are some other people that they don't say anything. They just repair, do the things, and they leave. But I guess that if you are paying for something, you have to know what is going on, okay? What's the problem? For that case, in the future, maybe you can have an idea what could it be, some other limitations, okay? So that happened to Mrs. Mendoza. Now let's go to Mr. Torres. And for this, I will need Edgar. Please, Edgar, could you help me? I had a problem.
Okay, I had a problem with the cards and gene. Mm-hmm. So I called for assistance. The mechanic was really fine. He was there really fast, and he was quick to fix my car's problem.
He gave
me details about the accident.
The incident.
Mm-hmm. And he gave me a report of it. Then I started the engine and everything was perfect.
Okay, so we can see that there is a big difference between the service that they received. In the case of Mrs. Mendoza, okay, can you see that that Mrs. Mendoza didn't know what happened in, well, on the contrary, Mr. Torres, he knew. He received details and all those things, okay? So there are two experiences totally different. So here we have these questions. And for these questions, I will need, let's see, Mercy, could you help me to read one or two? Merci.
Okay, perdón, teacher.
Tranquila.
Pensé que ya lo había activado. The Mrs. Mendoza had a problem with a method of payment.
Okay, ajá, tuvo problema con el método de pago.
Yes.
Yes, okay, what could it be?
Payroll.
Yes, it was the payroll, la nómina payroll system. And related to money, he even
charged
for a piece.
He broke.
Uh-huh, okay. Entonces, it says that this man broke a piece, quebró una pieza, and even charged to the Mrs. Mendoza's account. Aparte, le cobró. Entonces, charge, cuando decimos charge, significa carga, pero también es como cargar a la cuenta. ¿Ok? Cuando te la agregan a la factura. So, if you want to take notes, si quieren anotarlo para en el futuro, in any case, so that happens, yes. Thank you. And here we have number two. For number two, we'll have Manuel, could you help me? Did Mr. Torres?
Did Mr. Torres call his best friend for help?
Okay, what do you think? Call his friend or not? Yes or not?
Yes, I can read.
Mr. Torres, here.
Yeah. ¿Cómo sabía que estaba leyendo el otro lado?
Ya, ya ves. Joder, de repente.
Yeah.
Okay, the person... The expert was Mr. Torres' friend or not?
No.
No, right? He was what?
Mecánico.
Yes, he was a mecánico. Juan Mecánico. Yes, that's it. So, he received help.
Así lo hace usted.
No, mira, Carmencita, cómo se ríe. I don't know why Carmen is laughing. I don't know. She's so smiley. Ay, Carmencita. Okay. So,
yo nada he dicho, teacher.
No,
solo los escucho.
Y nos ve las reacciones. Ok, speaking, antonyms, los antonios, ok, antónimos. Choose one of the antonyms and read. For this, I will need, ¿quién tiene cara de inocente? Damari, no mucho, pero let's see, Damari. medio Damari. Ok, pick one, Damari. Remember, antonyms are opposites, okay? Are different or maybe contrary words, verbs. So you have to select one, okay? The one that you consider it is correct. Okay, Damari? Follow your heart. And after this, we have Helen.
Number one.
Easy.
Sam is a... the antonyms, ¿verdad?
Yes, no, but son antónimos, o sea, son opuestos. Solo elegí uno, el que te diga tu corazón. Clever or stupid, what do you think?
Hi, teacher, clever.
Okay, continue. Clever boy.
Sam is a clever boy. I always ask him for advice.
Yes, advice is consejo. Siempre le pido consejo. Okay, thank you. Helen, and after Helen, we're having Elsa.
Number two.
Okay.
I found my kid in the box under and there.
Under the table. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Table.
Yes, and we have Elsa and Diana.
Number six. If you are free in the evening, we can go to the concert.
Yes, that's it. If you're free, let's go. Diana, and after Dianita, we're having Jasmine.
Number seven. Tom's yes. car is very old. It needs repairing.
Yes, está viejito el carro aquí. Oh, my mío. Okay. And let's see, Jasmine, and then Claudia.
Number eight.
Mm-hmm.
He hates
theaters.
He never goes there.
Hmm? He doesn't like it. Okay, thank you. Next, Claudia, and then Marlon.
Number three. Hmm? The concert. Hmm? The concert was very dull.
Okay.
We didn't went to leave the concert hall.
Okay. El concierto estaba
tedioso.
Nosotros no queríamos dejar la sala de conciertos. Uh-huh. Is that okay?
Interesting.
I'm sorry. Uh-huh. How do you pronounce this word? ¿Cómo la pronuncias?
Interés, no.
No, Claudia, ese era el curso antes de que, cuando estaban chiquitos ustedes. Interesting. Tres sílabas. Interesting. Y la fuerza de voz está al inicio. Okay, thank you. Okay. Marlon, and after Marlon, we're having Charlie.
Of course. Number four. Ask your neighbor to make a music quieter. Quieter sería.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I have a terrible headache.
Yes, it te pasa a vos sometimes, right?
¿Cómo? Sin dolor de cabeza, quisiera que le bajen a la voz.
Yes, no. Definitely. Yeah. We all agree, man. Okay, Charlie and Carmencita.
I think Nick's behavior is bad because he insulted Sam.
Yes, insulted Sam. Thank you. And Carmen, number nine.
He always lends money to people. He isn't, how do you say, greedy.
Hmm? Yes. Okay. But in this case, borrows money is like, okay, lend. Do you remember the difference between lend and borrow, Carmencita? ¿Te recuerdas la diferencia?
Borrow es prestar.
¿Eh?
Y lend, no me acuerdo, pero por descarte, por la oración no era borrows.
Okay. Cuando tú dices, can you lend me? Vaya, le digo, por ejemplo, a Damari, que tiene pisto. Okay. Mari okay. has a lot of money. Okay. Entonces le digo, Damari, can you lend me? ¿Me puedes prestar? Y la dirección es de Damari hacia mí. Ok. Damari uh-huh. hacia mí. Y cuando decimos, can I borrow you? Es como que yo le estoy pidiendo a ella. Uh-huh. So, he
entonces
always...
aquí va lend.
¿Ah?
En este caso sería lend.
No, sería, es que lend es que él da el dinero. Pero borrow es que pide.
Ah.
Y greedy es avaro.
Sí.
Uh-huh. So he always?
He always borrow
mm-hmm. money to people. Money siempre to people. Le pide, siempre pide prestado. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Así
he
que.
Isn't greedy.
Yes, si quieren anótenlo en esta manera. Lend, dar prestado. Borrow, pedir prestado. Okay. No se han dado cuenta, have you noticed that, y eso lo he notado muchas veces, in Spanish, en español decimos, vaya, le voy a preguntar a Andrea, cuando le digo a Marlon, préstame un CD, o me prestas un CD, ¿quién va a dar el CD? Marlon a mí. Marlon, a mí, ¿verdad?
Y sí.
Ajá, ahora, si yo digo, le presté a Marlon un CD, ¿qué entendés?
Que usted le prestó a Marlon un CD.
Sí, sí, pero bueno, ¿qué, ¿en qué dirección? ¿De Marlon hacia mí o de mí hacia Marlon? Oí bien, le presté a Marlon un CD.
Podría ser que usted se lo haya prestado, o sea, le pedí prestado, ¿vale? Solo
pero le pedí prestado, es diferente. Entonces, yo siempre noto eso que la gente pues dice, yo lo presté. Cuando digo yo lo presté, es que yo se lo di. Pero hay gente que también entiende, yo le presté, es que yo le pedí prestado. Ajá, ¿se han dado cuenta?
Eso cae mal. Sí, eso cae súper mal.
Sí, sí.
Sí.
Lo que dijiste por dos y por mil. Exacto, porque yo comprendo, yo pedí prestado, le pedí prestado esto, y cuando yo se lo presté, ya se lo di, right? Entonces por eso les digo, lend es cuando ustedes dan prestado, y borrow cuando ustedes piden prestado, okay? So that's the difference, okay?
So that's it. Y en esa oración, teacher, ¿cuál era la respuesta correcta? ¿La puede
borrow, poner? Borrow. Porque greed, I'm sorry.
Sí, porque.
Es que
porque
aquí dice isn't. Sí, entonces, ajá. He always lends. Carmencita tenía razón, es que estoy enamorado.
O sea, él siempre
de
pide.
De mi trabajo, de mi trabajo. Man,
pide prestado.
Yes. He always lends, I'm sorry. No había listened, ya estoy ciego.
No, teacher dijo, pedir prestado y él siempre pide prestado.
No. Pero sí, Carmen, Maritza. Lo mismo que tú dices, así pensaba yo, mira, pero como que dice, él no es avaro. ¿Ok? Aquí, entonces.
Por eso siempre da.
Por eso siempre da. Ajá. Como Damari, que tiene pista y siempre da. So, that's why, dice, él siempre presta dinero, ¿sí?
Pero al principio nos dijo que Lent era de dirección de ella hacia mí.
De,
de dar.
De dar. Lent es dar. Y borrow, pedir. Ya, lend is that. Por ejemplo, le digo, Charlie, can you lend me your t-shirt? ¿Puedes prestarme tu camiseta? Can you lend me? En esta dirección. Por eso, lend es cuando das y borrow, pedís. Por eso dice, él siempre da dinero prestado porque él no es avaro. Entonces, él da dinero.
Perdón. Entonces, el ejemplo es, can you lend me?
Sí, aquí te lo voy a anotar para que lo tengan de un solo. Can you lend me? Sorry, it's happening. Esto siempre da dificultad.
Sí, da dolor de cabeza.
Can you lend me? Y la otra es, can I borrow you? Can you lend me? Can I borrow you? Okay. Cuando dices can you lend me es me prestas. Y can I borrow
you? Vaya, tú a mí. Tú a mí. Va. Yeah. Entonces pedir prestado, ¿verdad? Can you lend me?
Ajá.
Tú a mí. Yo te estoy pidiendo prestado.
No, es me prestas. Can I borrow you? Pues es pedir prestado. Lo que pasa es que es esto, mi hermano. No podemos decirlo literalmente en inglés y en español. Uh-huh. Pero vamos a anotarlo de esta manera, con las frases. Me prestas. Can you lend me? Me prestas. Can you lend me the eraser? Me prestas un borrador. Okay. Can I borrow you? Es igual. Me prestas. Ambos significan lo mismo. Solo que lend es cuando lend significa, aquí lo voy a anotar. Lend, dar prestado. Borrow, pedir prestado. Okay, that's the key. Esa es la cuestión. Cuando dice, can you lend me, can I borrow you? Ambos significan que siempre te van a prestar. Ya. Pero lend, solo la palabra lend, es dar prestado. Okay, por ejemplo, si tú eres fiador, if you have some quantity of money and you give money, y tú das, you are lending. Tú estás dando prestado, ¿ok? Pero si tú necesitas dinero, if you need money, you are borrowing. Tú estás pidiendo prestado, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, Andreita, que le quiere complacer al novio, entonces ella está pidiendo prestado para complacer al novio. So, she's borrowing. Pero como Marlon okay. tiene pisto, Marlon is lending.
Sí, inmediato le presto 50 centavos.
Solo va, dos cuadras para los dos. So, ok. Okay, guys, I guess okay. that now we are clear, right? Ahora sí ya tenemos una mejor idea, ¿verdad? Can you lend me? Can I okay. borrow you? No pueden decir, can you borrow me? Okay, eso ya estaría raro. Can I lend you? No, can I borrow you? Son las dos opciones. Can you lend me? Can I borrow you? Y lend, dar prestado, borrow, pedir prestado. Okay.
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 Teacher, ¿qué significa behavior? Perdón por la número 5.
Conducta.
Ah.
Conducta o comportamiento.
Okay.
Es importante, okay. For example, if you're talking about a problem, if you have a problem, why aren't you separated? Ah, because of her behavior. She is so complicated, blah, blah, blah. Entonces tenemos behavior. Y si le ponemos la U es behavior también, pero es comportamiento, pero es palabra tomada del inglés británico. Es como esa palabra color en inglés británico es color, pero siempre es color, color, color. Okay. Eso nada más. Ok, ok, nice guys. Yes,
como dijo lo de lending y borrowing.
¿No lo anotaste, Edgar?
No lo logré anotar, teacher.
Ok, Edgar. Bye.
No solo lo de lending. Lo demás sí lo logré entender.
Ok, ok, ok. Lend. Lend, cuando escuches lend, es dar prestado. Cuando escuchas borrow. Es pedir prestado. Si escuchas esta frase, if you listen, Charlie is lending a lot of money. Ah, Charlie has a lot of money and he is giving money to a lot of people. But if you listen, Kevin is borrowing a lot of money. Kevin needs money. Kevin doesn't have money. So he's asking, give me money to you, blah, blah. Ese es el punto, ¿ok? ¿Lo hice, Edgar?
Sí, teacher, yo sí. Okay. Yeah.
Perfect. That's it.
Gracias.
Wonderful. Anytime. When is the right time to tell a kid that he and she was adopted? We're going to start with Marlon this time. And then Diana.
I was thinking that maybe I can agree with Charlie, teacher.
Okay.
I think maybe it's not necessary to talk about
to that talk about topic. That.
Yes, we don't need to say, "Hey, you are adopted." Remember, because I don't want to hurt you. No, I think we don't need to talk about it, and maybe. I don't know. That's my opinion, teacher.
Yes, of course.
But no problem. That's a difficult topic. Yes. Complicated.
I think
I think it's not necessary to talk about it.
Okay. It is not necessary to talk about it. And it is, you don't know the reaction that the kid is going to have. Okay. Or that yes, person.
Definitely.
Maybe that is one of the most important points, right? Okay. And but yes, that depends on the parents. Okay. Yeah. But well, it is a good opinion. Better to not to mention that, and specifically or especially when the rest of people they don't know, no, it's not necessary. But when a lot of people, the surrounding people, they know, maybe that kid can receive those news,
of course, notices,
and that's something that maybe have incidents. And
yes, you can, yes, and but that's not, that's a different situation.
Mm-hmm. That's a different situation. But if
you know how to do everything very quietly, sería cuidadosamente,
yes,
or carefully.
Quietly.
Quietly, for don't have these problems or esos que traumas sería.
Yes, traumas. Yes, traumas.
Yes.
Or problems and difficulties.
Yes, I think you have to do the things very quietly, and I don't know. I think if you do it quietly, you don't need to talk about it.
Mm, okay. Very nice. Mm-hmm. Very nice, Marlo. Thanks for your opinion. Good. Now let's see Diana and then Jasmine. Anita, are you ready?
Just in my opinion, it could be signs this little one, and he also has the right to know his roots.
Ah, a very important word, roots. Roots, yes, very good one. And las raíces, where you come from, de donde vienes, maybe if you have your ancestors, if you have some parents, there are different situations that maybe can have incidents of what happened in that moment. For example, imagine if the kid is not look like. Look like significa parecerse. Por ejemplo, the kid looks like his mother. El niño se parece a su mamá. Oh, the girl looks like her father. La niña se parece a su papá. Okay. Y cuando decimos eso es. Cuando decimos look like es parecerse físicamente. Y cuando decimos it look like es personalidad. Okay. Me parece. Okay. So when you say, who do you look like? ¿A quién te pareces? Okay. Okay. Who are you look like? ¿A quién te pareces? En personalidad. So that's different. Okay. For example, Jasmine can see her baby. And she can say, the baby looks like me. La niña se parece a mí. Okay. And when the baby the baby looks like Ede.
Yes.
Okay, so that's one example. Okay, but maybe in the future you can see her personality, and maybe she is look like you. Quizás ella se puede parecer o se parece a ti. Personalidad depends. Okay. So related to this, as Diana says. The roots, okay? If you see who do you look like, a quien te pareces physically in the appearance, maybe you can see the difference and you want to know y tú quieres saber. Okay, but that's another point. Okay, Jasmine, and what's your opinion about this? What's the right time to tell a kid?
Is my opinion is similar of Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
Because in the future, she or he asked who is her or his parents. Mm-hmm. Empieza como lo de querer saber quiénes son, ¿verdad?
Okay. Yes. Okay, that's another point, right? Maybe it is good to not to say all the things if there is no necessity. Okay, that's similar to your opinion, right? Mm-hmm. You can continue with your life normally with no problems, right?
Yes.
Okay, but that's another point of view, and it is good. As I always say, I love listening to your opinions, your ideas, because that's what that is the most interesting part of these activities. Okay, thank you, Esme. Very nice. Now here we have how to use simple past yes no questions. Okay, this is something that we have studied. Remember that did is the past of do. Fácil, o sea, en presente. In present we say, do you like pasta? Do you work at night? And there are some words, some questions. Hay bastante preguntas. But in the past we just did. Did you like pizza yesterday? Did you work at night yesterday? So there are questions with did. Es el mismo uso. En lugar de do, utilizamos did. Okay? So here I will need for this. Helen, could you help me reading the questions? Did you call?
Yes, teacher.
Please.
Complicated that question, teacher.
Ah, okay. ¿Quieres participar? Bueno, pues. Ay, démosle, pues
perdón.
¿Se la regaste? No, ya, ni modo. Está inspirada, mujer, ok. Dale. So.
No, teacher, about that topic.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's lonely.
Okay. So you think it is not necessary to tell the kid, the boy? Mm-hmm.
No necessary.
Okay, mm-hmm. No necessary. Okay, maybe you can keep the secret. And there are a lot of families that have the same situation. They don't say anything and they live normally, or at least normally. Mm-hmm. And without any problem. Okay, thank you, Helen. Very nice. Ya veo que tenemos mucha iniciativa, Helen. Okay, now that Helen participated, I will need Andrea, please. Did you call? Sí, amaste a Juan Mecánico. Mira, Andrea, aquí dice. Okay.
Never.
No. No, yes, the mechanic. Come, Andrea.
Did you call me a mechanic to check your car? Did she pay extra money? Did we receive a report? Did they sing the letter? Sign the letter.
Sing es cantar, yes. Okay, here we have, yes, I did, no, I didn't. Yes, she did, no, she didn't, and so on. It is important to use the same subject and the answers, okay? So it is easy. Maritza, you start. Pick one of these. We already have the answers. So it means that you have to create the questions.
Okay.
What number, Maritza, please?
The number one.
Okay, please.
Did you send the email yesterday?
Yes, perfect. I'm going to type it. Send the what? The email. Okay, el yesterday es ya plante de Maritza. No estaba ahí, pero se escucha bastante bien. Did you send the email yesterday? Yes, I did. I sent the email. Okay, now let's listen to Mercy. And then we go with Elsa.
Number two.
Okay.
Did they ship the package?
Okay, good. Did they check the package? No, they didn't. They didn't check the package. Very nice. Elsa, and after Elsa, we're having Marlon.
Number five.
Mm-hmm.
Did he buy the toy?
Did he buy? Mm-hmm.
Buy.
Did he buy the new tire, el nuevo neumático? ¿Sí lo compró? Mm-hmm. Yes, he did. He bought a new tire. Perfect. Now let's see Marlon and Carmen.
Number four. Did you receive a copy of the receipt?
Uh-huh. Receipt? Receipt. Yes, that's it. Mm-hmm. Oh, we did it. That's it. we never receive a copy of the receipt. And that is something that it happens when you send emails or some documents. Okay, some people say, no, we didn't receive. And sometimes they are lying. Yes. Están mintiendo. Okay.
Yes.
Thanks, Margot. Carmen Cera, number three, please.
Okay. Did you turn on a game?
And did you? Mm-hmm. Okay, but we're talking about the car, Carmen Cera.
Did you? ¿Qué sería? ¿Y cuál es el verbo ahí?
Ah, sí, tu corazón, Carmencita. ¿Qué te dice tu cora?
Did you... Tú.
Ah, vaya, ¿cuál es el verbo?
Did. No.
Carmencita.
Yes, I did. Sí, the car turned.
Yeah. Did you turn on? Ahora, ¿cuál es el objeto? ¿De qué estamos
on
hablando?
On the car again.
Yes. Puede ser again o no. Did you turn on the car again? ¿O solo car? Yes, it did. The car turned again. Ahora, solo que en lugar de you, vamos a ponerle did. Okay. And did it turn on the car? Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's continue.
Teacher, y esa siempre iría con ed.
Ah, no. Con ed lo puse. I'm sorry. No va nada de con did, no va nada de. Thank you, Denita. Aquí vamos a tener otros ejemplos, ¿ok? So, cuando utilizamos did, no va de. Si lo puse, pues olvídenlo. No va nada de porque el did ayuda a modificar, ¿ok? So, make the past simple, positive, negative, or questions. For this, we're going to start with Andrea and then Maritza. ¿Ok? So, here we have, for example, I. No drink any beer last night, cosa que todos nosotros es correcto. So, in this case, Andreita, one example. I'm going to give you another. Te voy a dar otro ejemplo. Pero esta te voy a aliviar. What is the negative for the past?
Didn't?
Yes, didn't.
Uh-huh. I didn't drink.
Okay, I didn't drink any beer last night. No me tomé ninguna cerveza anoche. Yeah, congratulations. So that's it. Okay. And now, Andreita, another. Te voy a dar otra porque sos una voz.
What time did he?
Así como está.
Get up yesterday.
Yes, get up yesterday, yes. Los verbos cuando se utilizan didn't o did no cambian. Eso mm-hmm. es lo genial, ¿ok? Now let's go with Maritza, right? And after Diana. Mm-hmm.
Number two.
Okay.
She did the gong that was in the center of the cell.
Okay, perfect. But as it is affirmative, como es positiva, afirmativa, get lo vamos a pasar en el pasado. ¿Cuál es el pasado de get? Got on. Tenía el micrófono apagado, pero te leí los labios. Yes. Yes. She got on. Thank you, Diana. And we go with Mercy.
Okay, number five. Mm-hmm. I didn't change trains at Victoria.
Yes, I didn't change. Okay, good. Mercy.
Number six.
Okay.
We did wake up very late.
Okay. Como el did no se utiliza para afirmativo, Mercy. Do you know the past of wake? ¿Sabes el pasado de wake?
No se está limpiando. No recuerdo.
No está limpiando. ¿Qué? Tranquila, Marita. Ya. Okay.
Qué regañona.
Ya vimos que Maritza, ¿cuál sería? Be careful. Hasta rojita se nos puso ya. Ok. Ya escuchamos aquí cómo regaña Maritza, cómo regaña Carmencita. Ya escuchamos cómo regaña Diana. ¿Quién más? Y muchas otras cosas.
Okay. Marlon.
Marlon, Manuel. Manuel cuando se emociona.
Hey, teacher, yo en algún momento...
No, recuerdo qué dije.
A lo mejor me regañaron.
El de malo fue fuerte.
No, oiga. Hey. Lo estaba regañando, pobre Marlo.
Eso sí es increíble.
Ok. Ok. Mercy, ¿te acuerdas del pasado de wake? Es un verbo
no,
regular.
Teacher.
Ok, no problem. I'm going to help you. Woke. Woke up. Ok. Woke up. Ok. Diana, right? And after Diana, we're having Damari.
Ya estuvo.
I see. Yo... Sorry. Ok, Damari. And then,
hi, teacher.
Okay. Damari and then Edenilson.
What gave?
Mira aquí la pregunta.
Ajá. Sí. What did he?
Yes.
Gave.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. No sé por qué estoy poniendo el pasado. What did he give? Mm-hmm. His mother.
His mother for Christmas.
For Christmas, thank you. And then Nilsson, your turn, and then Carmen.
Number 9.
Yes, let's go.
We didn't use the computer last night.
Perfect. Carmen and then Beatriz.
Ya no se ve. Sí se ve. El 10, no sé por qué ya no lo veo.
Yes. Ok, no lo ves todavía.
No, teacher. Bueno, hagamos otro.
Ok, ahora.
El 4.
Ok, 4.
Sería, where did you get off the train?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Good. And who's next? Bea. And after Bea, we go with Kevin.
Number 10.
Yeah.
Did she make?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's a question, ¿verdad?
Pero está bien. Yes.
Okay. Did she make good coffee?
Yeah. Did she make good coffee? Hizo buen café. Okay. Perfect. Kevin, number 8. Are you ready?
Yes. I did receive 200 on my uncle's diet.
Okay. Pero como solo es afirmativo, no lleva el did. Okay. El pasado de receive, ¿cuál es?
I don't know, teacher.
Es un verbo regular. It's a regular verb. Fácil. Ok. I receive. Ok. Le voy a explicar algo por el afirmativo. Ok. Cuando utilizamos... Permisión. Vale, quiero que me pongan atención en esto, como siempre. Cuando utilizamos el pasado, we use, for example, I go to the park. En pasado, I went to the park. ¿Ok? ¿Se dan cuenta? Go cambió a went. Pero no podemos decir esto. Bueno, sí podemos, pero le voy a decir porque en... No lo hacemos. Cuando utilizamos el did en afirmativo, estamos haciendo, we are making emphasis, estamos haciendo énfasis. Un ejemplo. We are accusing, estamos acusando a quién, quiero ver a quién vamos a acusar, a Helen. Ok. We are accusing Helen. What did she do yesterday? ¿Qué hizo ayer? Entonces Helen dice, yesterday I went to the park. Ayer fui al parque, pero le decimos, we don't believe you, no te creemos. Yes, I did go to the park. Sí, yo sí fui al parque. Es como el presente. Ok. I clean the house. ¿Qué significa eso, Andreita?
Que yo limpio la casa.
Uh-huh. Ahora. Cuando decimos I do clean the house, se refiere a yo sí limpio la casa. Imagine you are discussing with your family, talking about housework, de las cosas del hogar en la casa. Y dicen, no, pero es que Andrea no ayuda. Mercy doesn't help. Mercy no hace nada en la casa. Andrea solo pasa acostada. Y usted dice, no, come on. I do clean the house. Yo sí limpio la casa. Entonces, cuando utilizamos el do, it's for emphasis. Es cuando hacemos un énfasis, ¿ok? Por eso, en afirmativo, en pasado no utilizamos did, utilizamos el pasado del verbo, went. Y en presente no utilizamos do, sino que simplemente el verbo. Pero cuando utilizamos do, hacemos un énfasis. ¿Ok? Is it kind of clear? ¿Está un poquito claro? Yes.
Teacher. Pero entonces, ¿por qué no se puede utilizar I did good to the park?
Se puede. Pero es cuando tú estás haciendo un énfasis. ¿Pero por qué hacemos énfasis? Because there's a doubt, porque hay una duda, porque están discutiendo, o porque no hay algo claro. So, you have to be clear. Mm. Tienes que ser bien conciso y claro. Okay? De lo contrario, decís I went to the park. Por ejemplo, decís, ¿qué hiciste ayer, Andrea?
Trabajé.
Pero si dices, no te creo, Andrea, no te creo. Teacher, yo sí trabajé. Ese sí trabajé es I did work. ¿Ok? Yes, Bea.
Y por ejemplo, si preguntamos, vaya, I do clean the house, pero si preguntamos, sería do you clean o did no. you clean? Podemos preguntar, do you clean?
Sí, pero este es presente. O, ¿limpias la casa?
Limpiaste la casa. Did
es pasado, limpiaste la casa. Imagine, Maritza llega. Maritza comes from work. Llega Maritza todo el trabajo a la casa. Tranquila, Maritza. And she sees that the house is a mess. Ve un desastre en la casa. The dirty dishes, platos sucios, the house upside down, de cabeza. What did you do? ¿Qué hicieron? No, mom, we cleaned the house. Limpiamos la casa. En pasado, we cleaned the house. No, you didn't. Y todavía uno de sus niños dice, yes, mom, I did clean the house. Yo sí limpié, but my brother didn't. Pero mi hermano no. So, en esos casos se utiliza, right? When you want to make emphasis, cuando quieren hacer un énfasis y que les crean, que de verdad les crean. So.
Y si le quiero preguntar a uno de mis estudiantes, por ejemplo, ¿terminaste? Le puedo decir, do you finish o did you finish?
Did you.
Y si le digo, ¿tú qué es? ¿Estás terminando o cómo?
No, ¿terminas?
Ah.
Eso se escucha raro.
Ajá. Okay. O sea, ya, ok. Uh-huh. Thank you.
Ok, aunque normalmente cuando se les dice así, mira. A los alumnos se les dice, are you finished? Y le dicen, yes, I'm finished.
Puedo preguntar, are you finished? Se escucha mejor que, did you finish?
Eso es lo más común. Are you finished? Yes, I'm finished. Or yes, I did. Oh, yes. Aunque se leería raro, estás terminado, ¿verdad? Estás algo así, ¿verdad? Sí, está raro eso, I know. But in the academy, it is very common. Okay.
Okay.
El mar lo está gozando. Okay, we are. Okay, we have to move. We have to move to another topic, my dear friends. Okay, so let's see who is in charge. We have some other. Kilomar, relax. Okay, we go to the listening part. So I need you to pay attention and please take your pen or pencil ready. Okay, let's go.
Pero entonces, I was, I
Serene.
Lucy, are you there?
Chicos, soy yo, no se escucha.
Hello, hello. No, no, I'm sorry. Que estaba aquí en otras menesteres. Ok, now.
Audio de WhatsApp nos están poniendo.
Sí, no, es que ahí los mando. Es que ahí los voy guardando. Ok, let's go.
This is Larry Watson here, Sports News. In tennis, the Brazilian Diego Garcia reached the semifinals of the French Open. 26-year-old from Sao Paulo, knocked out in the first round last year in Paris, managed to overcome the Swiss player Hans Gruller in four sets. Garcia said he was delighted with his victory and put it down to having changed his coach last winter. The two Americans, Rod Langer and Brad Wilson, will play in the second semifinal tomorrow to decide who will play Garcia.
Okay, Bea, can you hear well? ¿Puedes escuchar bien?
Es que lo escucho como cortado, pero no sé si es mi inter.
Okay, Damari, can you hear clear?
Se escucha a lo lejos.
Okay, I'm going to give like more audio. See.
This is
okay.
Larry.
Now again.
This is Larry Watson here with Evening Sports News. In tennis, the Brazilian Diego Garcia reached the semifinals of the French Open. The 26-year-old from Sao Paulo knocked out in the first round last year in Paris, managed to overcome the Swiss player Hans Gruller in four sets. Garcia said he was delighted with his victory and put it down to having changed his coach last winter. The two Americans, Rod Langer and Brad Wilson, will play in the second semifinal tomorrow to decide who will play Garcia.
Okay, la última vez, porque no lo escucharon bien la primera.
This is Larry Watson here with Evening Sports News. In tennis, the Brazilian Diego Garcia reached the semifinals of the French Open. The 26-year-old from Sao Paulo knocked out in the first round last year in Paris, managed to overcome the Swiss player Hans Gruller in four sets. Garcia said he was delighted with his victory and put it down to having changed his coach last winter. The two Americans, Rod Langer and Brad Wilson, will play in the second semifinal tomorrow to decide who will play Garcia.
Okay, let's see in this case. Mercy, and then Manuel.
Ay, no escuché muy bien, teacher.
Vamos.
Solo escuché San Pablo. Over.
Okay.
Fine. Open.
Okay. Excellent. Thank you, Mercy. Edgar and Helen. Ah, no, Manuel. Manuel Iba. Manuel Iba. I'm sorry. Manuel and Edgar.
Lo estaba esperando por WhatsApp. Dijo que yo le iba a mandar, ¿no?
No, hombre. Para nada.
No, no escuché bien, de verdad.
No, nothing. Nada, Manuel. Okay, Edgar and Helen, please.
Okay. Escuché 26 San Pablo, García Sells, Orlando and Brad Wilson will play to tomorrow, Diego García y to overcome.
Okay, yes, very good. Helen? And then
last week tomorrow, no sé si era Diego García.
Okay.
Open y player only, teacher.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, what about the Mari and then Carmen?
Voy a inventar.
Uh-huh.
In two American Roland and Bra Wilson, who is playing García?
Brad, Brad. Es que Brad es Brasil. Ajá. Brad, Brad.
Brad, Brad Wilson.
Yes, oh, that's it. Yeah. Wilson. Mm-hmm. Good. Carmen and Maritza.
Okay, Sport News. tennis de Brazilian Diego Garcia. Final of the game open first round to overcome coach Land Wisdom.
Okay, good. And Maritza.
26 years old from Sao Paulo.
Okay. Yes, 26 years old. Okay, this is the paragraph. I will play again. So you can read and listen at the same time.
This is Larry Watson here with Evening Sports News. In tennis, the Brazilian Diego Garcia reached the semifinals of the French Open. The 26-year-old from Sao Paulo knocked out in the first round last year in Paris, managed to overcome the Swiss player Heinz Gruller in four sets. Garcia said he was delighted with his victory and put it down to having changed his coach last winter. The two Americans, Rod Langer and Brad Wilson, will play in the second semifinal tomorrow to decide who will play Garcia.
Okay. And we have 23 minutes, 23 minutos, and we finished. So in this case, to the speaking activity, we will have Bea, are you ready?
Yes.
Please, go ahead.
Pero me quiero ver. Okay. When is right? Ay, no, pero me que sí.
Que te vea bien natural. ¿Y qué hace? Pero salen del Cora, ¿ok? Bueno, no del Cora, pero son bien.
Agarro, espéreme. ¿De qué están hablando? Ay, espéreme.
¿Por quién vas a votar?
Sí, que sí.
Ajá.
Think it's correct to tell when it's a kid.
When it's a kid.
Because no sé, alguien más se lo puede decir y puede dañarlo.
Okay. Yes.
O asegurarse, no sé. It's be.
That is something that we're talking about. Mm-hmm.
The other person, the other person, not.
There is a risk. Hay un riesgo. There is a risk that mm-hmm. other people can say that information, can tell what happened to the boy. Okay, so that's the reason why you are saying that it's better to say or to tell the kid the reality. Mm-hmm. Thank you. And Mercy. Mm-hmm. Please, and after Mercy, we're having Kevin.
Okay, I consider that at 5 or 6 years, when they can already have the ability to understand the concept of adoption.
Very interesting.
Explain in the simplest way possible.
Okay, simplest way, excellent opinion. Mm-hmm.
Sí, considero que alguien más se lo puede mencionar y quizás al enterarse por otras personas pueden pensar que por qué no se lo dijeron y considerarlo como algo malo.
Okay, sometimes it happens that some other parents or otros padres, they know what happened. And the other parents comment and there are some other kids that they listen. So sometimes the kids say the things maybe to hurt or not. A veces lo dicen para herir o no, ¿verdad? La otra persona. Sometimes the kids are like really hard. A veces son difíciles los niños. A veces dicen cosas bien dolorosas. So it is a risk. It's part del riesgo. Thank you, Mercy. Kevin, your turn. And then Elsa.
Okay. In my opinion, I think that is the best thing is when he is still a child,
mm-hmm.
that it does not affect him so much como cuando él está en la etapa de la adolescencia, que esté preparado.
Okay, teenager. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's another point. Okay, thank you, Kevin. And Maritza.
No,
Maritza ya pasaste, ¿verdad, Maritza? Okay, Claudia. Claudia Díaz. Ah, Elsa, teacher. Sorry. Elsa and then Claudia. Yes, Elsa, please.
I think that it should never be said. Okay. Because the psychological reaction can be barrier.
Or can be negative, right? The reaction.
Yes. Yo tengo, lo puedo decir en español, yo creo que cuando uno adopta a un niño, ¿por qué va a andar diciendo que es adoptado? Es su hijo. Okay. La posición o el estatus es otra cosa, pero
now,
no tengo que estar diciendo que es adoptado, es okay. Mi hijo.
Good. Now, it's part of the family, okay? So that's it.
Yes.
Thank you. Claudia Diaz, are you there? And,
yes, teacher.
Y vamos con Helen with the song. Helen, be ready, please. Okay, Claudia.
Okay, I think it is a topic to explain little by little in a different way so that he can understand.
In different ways, that's another opinion, right? In different ways, so the kid can understand, okay, little by little, not completely, yes, at once, no de un solo, okay? Thank you, Claudia. Very nice. Helen, are you ready with the song? We want to see what you have.
Yes, teacher.
Dele con todo.
Oh. Ay. Si no puedo compartir.
Pues comparta. Amar es compartir.
No.
Ok. No te estreses, tranquila. Aquí Andreita está bien estresada, la esposa.
Ay, no, ya me estresé.
Tranquila, relax. ¿Ya encontraste? ¿Estás en la computadora o en cel?
En cel, teacher.
Vaya, pero ahí abajo aparece, ¿verdad? ¿Quién, Andreita, tú lo hiciste con el celular? ¿Verdad? No. ¿Quién le hizo con el celular? Ok, en la parte de abajo aparece Charlie, no, ¿verdad? Ajá, en la parte de en medio aparece compartir pantalla, ¿right? O share screen.
De hecho,
share.
Es el único que aparece en verde. Es el único verde que aparece en verde.
Sí, pero es que tengo varias opciones, teacher.
¿Qué más tenés abierto, Helen? Ok, dale, cuidado.
Dale en foto.
Van a salir todas las fotos.
No, that's dangerous.
No, porque primero tenés que seleccionarla.
La foto, vaya. Y andate a galería y entre todas las imágenes de Piolín y de Jesús que tenés, accedes a la imagen y luego te vas a Zoom. Le das compartir y ahí te va a salir esa opción, ¿verdad, Charlie? Te va a salir ya la opción porque ya la tenés en segundo plano.
Ay, no.
Yeah. Bueno, no vayas a cambiar de foto. Eso. No vayas a cambiar de foto.
Gracias.
No.
Ay, no. Qué estresante.
Bueno. Bienvenida a mi mundo. Ok. So, okay. No, mentira. Ok, I know
there's something in the walk of your smile. I get notion from the look in your eyes, yeah, your boy, I love, but that love falls apart. Your little piece of hell turned to dark, listen to your heart. When hell calls for you, listen to your heart, there's nothing else you can do. I don't know where you're going, and I don't know why. But listen to your heart before you tell him goodbye. Sometimes your warden is this pain, is war. The precious moment I are or lost. In the right, yeah. They sweet, white, and nothing
is what it seems. The feel of belonging to your dreams.
Okay, thanks. Does anybody know this song? Creo que ya sé cuál es.
Listen to you.
Yes, I guess that's it. And who is the singer? I don't know who is the singer.
Roxette.
Roxette.
Yes,
the band.
Es romántica.
Yes, Roxette is the band, right?
It's a band. It's a band.
It's a band. Okay. Creo que sí. Qué romántica. Okay. And necesita. Okay. So you already colored the words, right? We have verbo.
Solo que ahí me equivoqué, teacher. Error de ortografía.
Yes, a veces pasa. El amor hace eso. Okay. Okay.
Sería verbo.
The verb. No.
The verbs.
Yes.
Get. Build.
Build. Build.
Build. I'm sorry. Yes.
Okay, Helen. Very nice, yes. Because I can see that the verbs are in red, but we have irregulars in purple, right? Five, yes. Swept, but no, también es, it's also an irregular, pero, but it's okay. In the regular, okay. We have listen, look, turn, see, yes. Okay, very nice. And okay, present continuous, right? Going, calling, belonging, and the adjective little, dark, yes, precious. Precious.
Ahí no. Tenía duda, teacher.
¿Dónde?
En esa frase, lost in the.
In the, the tide. Ajá, no, are lost. Lost es, ¿cómo se llama? Ese es adjetivo, solo lost, solo lost. Okay, very good, Helen. I know that you, it took time. Tomó tiempo hacer eso. Okay, con cuidado.
Ay, es estresante.
Deja de compartir con cuidado, no puedo hacer la imagen ni nada. Relax. Yes,
teacher.
Yes, okay, ya. Okay. Ya, sí, y sudando, sudando la Helencita.
Sí.
Mírala, pues ya toda brillosa. Yes, I know.
Okay,
thank you, Helen. For tomorrow, we have Kevin's song. Okay, Kevin?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, so be ready for tomorrow. And we're about to finish 12 minutes, 12 minutos, and we finished, okay? So for this, we will listen to Eden Nilsson. Are you over there, Eden Nilsson? When is the right time to tell a kid that he, she was adopted? Eden, are you over there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, please go ahead.
I think that it's not necessary to tell at the baby.
Okay.
Because if I decide to adopt him, sería verdad?
Okay, yes, adopting. In the case of a boy, yes.
Okay. And then I accept him.
Accept him. Okay.
As a part of my family.
Oh, yes.
Independent, if yo lo concebí, o yo lo...
I conceived.
O no. I decide that he is part of, he or she is part of my family.
Yes, now he or she belongs, ya pertenece, okay? It's part of. Belongs, okay. Thank you, Eden. It's a very nice idea. Edgar, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Please.
Okay. I think that at the age of 7 years.
7 years, you consider it is a good age, good time.
Seven or nine.
Okay.
Because it is an age where they are not yet rebellious, as in adolescence.
Yes.
And I think that that age, they can already understand what it means to be adopted.
Okay. Related to what you're saying, Edgar, the kids are really intelligent. We, as adults, we think that kids are not so smart, but they're very clever. Son muy listos ellos. They understand a lot of things, but depends on the way you explain it. Because as we can say, but the kids are not going to understand. Yes, this is a difficult topic, but related to different topics, they understand a lot about different ideas, situations, and things that they see. Okay, but depends of us, depende de nosotros, okay? Okay, Edgar, very nice. What about now, if Carito do you have your opinion about this, Carito Ventura? You tell me if you can, okay? If not, you can text me. And here we have also Manuel. Are you ready with this opinion?
Okay.
Yeah, please, go ahead.
I think, ¿cómo se dice? Se debe.
It must.
It must prepare the child.
Yes.
From a litter. Mm-hmm. And talk the, when they use, when they, he'll have, cuando él tenga uso de razón.
Ajá, yes. Yeah.
Lo correcto es que sepa la verdad, ¿no?
Yes, when he is aware, okay, when they're reasoning, okay, very nice. Thank you, Manuel, very good point. Now we're going to check the conversations, and here we have two, okay? This is changing dress. Esto es para cambiar los vestidos, okay? Here we have A and B. I would like to exchange this dress. And the other person says, you can exchange this dress with anything of the same value. Value. Is there anything on sale today? I'm sorry, there are no sales today. Our dress is going to be on sale. Everything's going to be on sale next weekend. That's great. I'll wait. See you the next weekend. Okay, I'll see you then. And number two. This dress doesn't fit correctly. Es lo que les decía. It doesn't fit. Fit es cuando algo no te queda. Maybe a dress, a shirt, a blouse. So this dress doesn't fit correctly. No problem. Shop around until you find something you like. What's on sale today? You can wait until next weekend. You can save some money. Do you know what's going to be on sale? You'll be happy to know that everything in the store will be on sale. I won't miss that. Miss es como no me voy a perder nada. I won't miss that. I'll wait until next weekend. Great. Bring lots of cash so you can buy lots of things. Okay. So I'm going to check this. 3 minutes. 3 minutes of practice. Okay. So see you in a couple of seconds. I already sent the conversation. Ya les envié las conversaciones. So, let me see. You can check. Pueden revisar in the WhatsApp group. Okay, see. Okay. See you in 3 minutes.
¿Por qué me dejó solita?
No, tú no has entrado.
Ya entré ya rato.
en el 10 debe de estar.
En el 9 me mandó.
No.
Sí, aquí dice, mire.
Vaya, ahí está.
Estoy en sala 9.
Ahí está, Chávez.
En el 9 me ha mandado.
¿Acepta ahorita el 9? ¿Pudiste?
Shop around. Teacher, ya que está aquí, ¿cómo se pronuncia la B? Shop around.
Number one or two? Two. Yes, shop around. Mm-hmm.
No, the next word.
Until you find something you like. Until.
Until. Thanks. No problem. Shop around. Around until you
shop around until find something you like.
What's on sales today?
If you can wait until next weekend, you can save some money.
Do you know what's going to be on sale?
You'll be happy to know.
I would like to exchange this dress.
You can exchange this dress with anything of the same value.
Is there anything on sale today?
I'm sorry, there are not sales today.
Hello, qué rápido. Okay, let's see. ¿Qué pasó, Damari? ¿La carita de pícara que tenés? Okay. And we're going to wait. We're about to finish. Ya vamos a terminar. Ya quiere descansar. Almost, almost. Sé que Mercy quiere relajarse, pobrecita. A very hard day. Yes, difficult Thursday. But tomorrow's Friday, ya mañana viernes chiquitito. So, you can go to the church, pueden ir allá. Ese, okay, you can do. Carmen, sí, tranquila, Carmen, ya casi, ya casi. Oh. Okay, I'm going to check the attendance list and you say hi, hello, and we finish. Mercy, hello there. Okay, Mercy, creo que sí se fue a dormir. Okay, Mercy. Andrea.
Hi.
No, teacher, aquí estoy.
Okay, good. Charlie.
Present.
Good. Carmen.
I'm here.
Acomodada ya. Claudia.
Present.
Thank you, Carito.
Present.
Pizza.
Present.
Good. Diana.
Good night.
Good night. Ya me estoy echando un momento. Ede, still there.
Present.
Nice. Edgar.
Present, teacher.
Elsa.
Present.
Damari.
Me.
Yeah. Helen.
Present, teacher.
Kevin.
Present, teacher.
Noel.
Present.
Marlon, thank you. Jasmine.
Present.
Jasmine and Bea.
Present.
Okay, two things. Helen, ¿te me quedas? Because we have the 10-minute session. Si se preguntaban qué significa what's on sale, la pregunta es qué está en oferta. What's on sale? Okay. Ahí aparece en la conversation. What's on sale? ¿Qué hay en oferta? ¿Qué está en oferta? Okay.
En útil, teacher.
¿Mm?
Útil.
Until hasta. Until. Por ejemplo, until now. Okay. Until now. Oh, see you until tomorrow. Te veo hasta mañana. See you until tomorrow. Okay. Hasta. Okay. So, goodbye, my friends. Have a good night. Vayan a descansar. See you tomorrow.
Bye, teacher.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye bye. Qué rápido se fueron. ¿Ya querían ir?
Sí, me imagino.
Vaya, no te escondas, Helencita. Vaya, entonces, do you want to review any topic? ¿Querés que revisemos algún tema?
Sí, teacher, los verbos. No, lo del dire y lo del din.
Vaya, ok.
Eso, no, no, no mucho.
¿Cómo estás con el negativo?
Ay, perdido.
Permítame. Que ayer lo comenzamos a hacer. Okay. You know that there are verbs that they have there. Tiene su pasado, ¿verdad? Ok.
Uh-huh.
Estos son los irregulares. Entonces, para los regulares, en afirmativo, no necesitamos el did. Solo necesitamos ponerlos en pasado. Bien, elegime dos de aquí, please. Select two.
El self.
Uh-huh.
Sería. Ay.
¿Mm? No, aquí está, no inventé. Okay, another.
Ay, el otro sería.
Uno fácil.
Ya no me acuerdo.
Vamos, hay varios fáciles.
Right.
¿Mm?
Round.
Row. Okay. Row.
El otro le dije.
Ah, vaya. Ah, run. Is that run? Ok. Entonces, aquí están en presente. Ok. Y aquí están en pasado. En afirmativo. Ahora. Tenemos. Sí. No. Ok. Vamos a utilizar el, ¿cómo se llama? El didn't. Para todo tipo de verbos, regulares o irregulares. Y mira lo fácil que es que no necesitamos cambiar los verbos. Fácil, los verbos como lo conoces en presente, pero le pones el didn't y están en pasado. ¿Ok? Vamos a poner un ejemplo. Vamos con la número dos.
Marta.
Ajá, right. Marta. Vaya, eso es en presente. Ahora la quiero en pasado, pero en negativo. Ajá.
Entonces, sería Marta.
Ajá, seguí el ejemplo del cuadrito. Marta.
Dire. Write a little.
Write a
little.
Ahora vamos a ver, ahora, four.
Pedro en mí. Sería siempre con el dire.
Yes.
Okay.
Did that?
Right company.
Right. Okay. Ya viste. No es tan difícil. Ahora, para el verbo. Be, para el verbo to be se utiliza wasn't o weren't, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, ¿cuál es el verbo be? El verbo be lo podemos ubicar aquí, am, are, is. ¿Ya viste? En lugar de am, vamos a utilizar
el was.
En lugar de are, vamos a utilizar
el weren.
Y en lugar de is, vamos a utilizar el
was.
Wasn't.
Wasn't.
Eso es negativo. Si solo fuera afirmativo, was. Ok, vale. Bien. En cuenta esto. Aquí tenemos esto. Vaya. ¿Elegí cualquiera de todas esas? ¿Cuál?
La primera.
Ok. ¿Cuál es el pasado de go?
Go on.
No, ¿cuál es el pasado del verbo go?
No me acuerdo.
Went. Ok.
Vaya,
si tú quieres decir que ellos fueron a la playa, decimos they went to the beach. Ok. Ahora, pero siguiendo el ejemplo que acabamos de ver, si lo queremos hacer negativo, ¿cuál vamos a utilizar? ¿Qué auxiliar vamos a utilizar?
El didn't.
Yes. Y el verbo. En normal no lo vamos a poner en pasado, lo vamos a poner como en presente. ¿Qué es?
Go.
Fácil, ya viste. El didn't hace todo el trabajo. El didn't es el que te ayuda a hacer el pasado. Bien, hagamos otra en negativo en pasado. Solo vamos a utilizar el didn't y el verbo que está ahí en el cuadrito. ¿Qué otra?
Sería... el... The girl. Right?
The girl, ajá. ¿Cómo sería en negativo pasado?
Drought, para que me diga usted.
Ajá, muy bien, drove. Si lo queremos poner en afirmativo, así ve. The girl drove a sport bike. Pero si lo queremos en negativo.
Sería, I didn't.
No hay, simplemente el.
Didn't.
¿Y el verbo, qué verbo es?
Sería, no lo pondríamos en pasado, sino que así lo dejaríamos. Drive.
¿Ya viste que está fácil?
Ay.
Es que solo le tienes que usar el didn't. Eso es el que te ayuda. Y para las preguntas, solo utilizas el did. Y los verbos no los cambias. ¿Ya viste que lo más complicado solo es en afirmativo? Que tenés que ver que es irregular. Tenés que ver si es regular, ed, y ver, ¿verdad? Modificarlo.
Ajá, ya en pasado ya no.
No, pero ya en negativo es fácil. Mira. Sí, vamos a hacer otra negativa. Hagamos otra negativa en pasado, utilizando el did.
Ok. Einstein. Get.
Muy bien. ¿Cómo sería acá?
Get.
Pero en negativo. Pero en negativo.
Cambiaría, sería get.
Vale. Fácil. Vaya, así que lo que te sugiero, Helen, es que, porque esto, ¿ya hiciste estos ejercicios en la plataforma?
No, ahora los iba a hacer.
Vaya, entonces te va a ser más fácil porque ya sabes cuál es el didn't, sabes cómo podría ser con did, porque no lo vas a cambiar entonces. Y voy a ver si les pongo un poquito más de ejercicio, porque este tema lo vimos el módulo pasado, pero lo estamos repasando y lo vamos a volver a repasar para porque no es tan, ¿cómo se llama?, tan fácil. Tiene su dificultad, yo lo sé.
Yo me confundo, la verdad. Pero ya más o menos.
Sí, pero vamos a ir teniendo más práctica, ¿oíste?
Poco a poco. Ok, teacher.
Bien, Helen, ten cuidado entonces porque se nos acabó el tiempo. Descansa. Ok. Bye bye.
See you, teacher. Bye.
Hasta tomorrow.
Tomorrow, teacher.